Somewhere in a We Know, maybe I liked that song, actually, coming to think of it. But I don't recognise any of the other songs. I don't like Somewhere in a We Know. I don't like that song. What's Her Face? She did a really good cover version for it for the John Lewis ad, didn't she? Ah, Kelly's. Do you know what? She did better singles than she did albums. I think the reason why I've got this is obviously because it is the greatest hits. So cut out there. I hate you so much right now. Ah! I love that song. And Milkshake. My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard. Love that. What else is on here? There's another really good one. Finest Dreams as well. I liked the Richard X remix thing. I loved that. Truth or Dare. Don't remember that, I don't think. But, no, I did actually like Kelly's, but on your singles or albums, I can remember getting not very well received, so I never bought any of her albums apart from The Greatest Hits. Kelly Clarkson, Breakaway. The Killers, I think of all the Killers albums. Killers, Hot Fuss, and Killers, Sam's Town, Killers, Sawdust, and yeah, that's it. Katie Tunstall, I like her. I liked the song Black Horse and the Cherry Tree and The Other Side of the World and Suddenly I See, which is used on the film Devil Wears Prada. Who's next? Well, obviously there's going to be a lot of Carly albums. So I've got Carly, the Abbey Road Sessions. I think Carly Minogue's pretty much international except the USA. I do like Carly Minogue, Ultimate Carly Minogue Light Years, Carly Minogue Showgirl Homecoming Live, Carly Minogue, I think this is X, yeah, or is it 10, we don't know, that's like the Apple phone, isn't it? Is it X or is it 10, Kim Marsh, gosh, got a Kim Marsh album, she was in ESA. If you remember that embarrassing single CD that I own, it's embarrassing now. I think I liked Standing Tall on it, and that was the only song I liked on the album. It's another album I don't listen to much at all. Let's Go! You see, this was like really popular in the 2000s, such as Something. Very, very generic, disposable pop music, really. But really good. I do like this album very much. Except the English translation, she does say the word leather instead of letter. She says, I wrote a leather. Instead of saying, I wrote a letter. Or letter. And it was really funny. Anyway, Liberty X was really popular. There was the runners-up to ESA. And Liberty X was really good. And then all of a sudden, there wasn't. It was like a sudden, it's like their third album. I think, Thinking It Over, Liberty X, was the first one. Then there was Being Somebody, which was really good. Then I think they had one more album and nobody bought it. It's something ridiculous like that. I think it sold like about a few hundred copies or something. Best of Lighthouse Family. I liked Lifted and... We are gonna be forever, you and me. You will always something or other. I don't know the words. Love. Lily Allen. That was, she's the one who did the cover version of Keane. I've gone off Lily Allen. I think her personality and her as a person has put me off of her and her music. So, but I did like Not Fair. It's not fair and I think you're really mean. I think you're really mean. Oh, you just care. Something like that. Linkin Park. I've got two of their albums. I've got Meteora and Hybrid Theory. Don't know why. Actually, oh yeah, I do know why. I do actually like them. They did do a cover version, didn't they, of Adele's Hello or something? Can't remember, but it was really good. Anyway, he's dead now, isn't he? So unfortunately, don't think we're going to get much more out of him because I don't know if they're going to replace him as a lead singer. I don't know. Patricia McNeil. There's two songs that I like from her, and I bought the album because maybe I had one or both on. Let's have a look. Ain't That Just the Way I liked, and Stranded. Ain't that just the way that life goes down, 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 down. That's that. And that is That Sad completed, and it's only took me 40 minutes. Oh, excuse me. Do you say excuse me when you cough? Pardon me? Excuse me? Whatever. I've said it now. What's on the other side? Macy Gray. Macy Gray was really popular when I was at school. So this is like 98, 99. Because I left in 2000. I try to say goodbye and I choke. Try to walk away and I stumble. I love that song. What was the other one that I liked? I've committed murder and I think I got away. I love that song. Number 8 on this is such a good song. I don't think, did you release it as a single? Can't remember. Don't hear much about Macy Gray anymore though. I don't know why. Oh, maybe we'll go with the Madonna. Yeah, there's going to be a lot of Madonna. Oh, am I actually even on camera? I'm not even on bloody camera, am I? There we go. So, here we go with Madonna. I've got Madonna American Life. I've got Madonna Celebration, which was a compilation of all the greatest hits. I've got Madonna, what's this one called again? Summer on the Dance Floor? Confessions on the Dance Floor, isn't it? I liked that album. Oh, yeah, I'll go through if I liked them or not. American Life? It wasn't a great album of theirs, was it? Obviously, you can't really include Celebration because that's a compilation album. I did quite like Confessions on the Dance Floor. I didn't like Hard Candy very much at all, Madonna's Hard Candy, but I did like one of the songs very much. Which one was it? Was it 4 Minutes with Justin Timberlake I liked? I think it was. Yeah. I think I only liked one or two songs on that album. Wait, what else have Madonna ever got? MDNA, which I did like very much. Yeah, Girl Gone Wild, Gang Bang, I'm Addicted, all the rest of it, yeah, I liked that. You can be a doll, you can be a boy tight, in the nick of time, success, like a ransom. Something like that, anyway, the Nicki Minaj bit. Madonna Music, I loved that one, I loved that album. And, probably one of the best albums. I really wish Madonna did more Ray of Light. So well done to, who was it who said I would have Madonna's Ray of Light? Because that was very specific. I think that's maybe just because it was so common that I was going to have Madonna's Ray of Light. Madonna Ray of Light. That was Dominic Fox. Yep. Well done to you, Dominic. You guessed right. This one is my only pirated CD that I own in my entire lot of CDs here. These are all proper CDs except this one. It's not mine. I think my sister got it off somebody. I don't know. Madonna Something to Remember, and I actually remember nothing about this album, so I don't know why I've still got that. That's, come on, go in. It's quite annoying because it's just on normal A4 paper sliced up. Who's next? Mark Almond. I got this and I don't know why, because I didn't like this album. I don't know why I've got that. I didn't like that one at all. I do like the song Something's Got Hold of My Heart, though, but it's not on the album. Mariah Carey, Greatest Hits, which is a lie, because it doesn't have the proper version of the only song on there that I think I would listen to more of, and it's All I Want for Christmas Is You, but it's some crappy remix. What was it? All I Want for Christmas. So So Def Remix, featuring Jermaine Dupri and Lil Bow Wow. And it's the most annoying, stupid remix. It's got all that stupid generic remix tat in it. When they remix a song, and all they do is go, and yeah, say what, all the way through it. And it's just like, that is not a remix. That is just necessary words. And it's really R&B-ish. The whole point of, I feel quite strongly about this song, don't I? But I love Mariah Carey's song for All I Want for Christmas Is You, just because of how cheesy and trashy it is. It's a great song. I mean, you can't go any Christmas without going out, All I Want for Christmas Is You, is it? Anyway, that was a bit of a rant, wasn't it? No, I just felt strong about it. It was not a rant. It was just, I've got a Mark Ronson album. I don't know why I've got this. Because Toxic on this, the Britney Spears song, is sung by Tiggers, whatever it is, and Valerie, Amy Winehouse. Yeah, the Toxic on this version is actually really good. I like that. It's more of a edgy sort of song. Oh yeah, I do remember actually on this. I've got another song that's got data rot, and it is a Coldplay one. So it's Coldplay is going to be up here somewhere, and the one of the albums has started all cracking up. Where is it? Coldplay. I've wasted so much time on this trying to find it now, haven't I? Oh no, I've got it. Let me just do that so I know where I'm up to. It's not that one. So it's a reason why people might not want to keep CDs. It's this one, I think. Is it this one? No, it's not that one. Oh my god, I can't find it now. Well, anyway, yeah, I've got a Coldplay album that's got some data rot on it, and I'm really annoyed about that. It's all like cracked up and stuff. I can't find it now, so I'm going to have to give up. Anyway, believe me, it's all cracked, and it's an event in a couple of months, or maybe a year time or so. I won't be able to play it anymore, because it started from the centre of the CD, so it won't be able to read it. Mark Ronson, is that another one that's got data rot on it? I don't think it has. No, it's not. I've got, I think I know two for sure, but I thought there might have been a third. Who was this? Mary Benn? Oh, Mary Benn! Yeah, she was one on X Factor a couple of years ago, wasn't it? She was really good. She sang It's a Man's World, and she was really, really good. This is a man's world, and it would be nothing without a woman or a girl. For me personally, not a song that I really agree with. Matt Cardell. I've got Matt Cardell song for. Oh yeah, it's got a song featuring Mel C, Loving You, which I thought was going to be a much bigger song, but it wasn't. Oh yeah, we'll go with the Melanie C stuff. So Melanie C, Beautiful Intentions, which was her third album. I love this album so much. She's got one of them songs that pokes the finger in the eye of the music industry again, which is Next Best Superstar. And I loved that song so much. I still do. I love the song Next Best Superstar. It's such a good song. You're the next best superstar. The next best superstar. Her original first solo album. I love this one. It's got I loved Go, a Northern Star. Going Down was an audition song for X Factor. Got me through the first few rounds all the time. There you are, going down that third one down. Then there's I Turn to You, which I think was an international hit. I turn to you like a flower leaning towards the sun. I've got it twice. I turn to you. There's a reason for that. I think it's because one of them's got data rot. Was it because one of them's got data rot? No, it's because one of them's got the remix on it, that's why. So I actually bought that album twice, but only from Pound Shop. The second one. What's the next one? Melanie C's Reason, which was her second album. This one didn't do as well. And she even says herself that she really regrets having one of the songs released as a single because she didn't want it released as a single, which was On the Horizon. And I agree. It is a good song, but not a single. It was really... It was like a really B-sidey sort of theme to that song. I did used to like Mel C a lot. Used to, I still like Mel C. Got Mel C stages, that's where she sang loads of songs from musicals and everything. So, oh god, get in. Which, there's loads of good ones on there. There's one on here that I love singing. Another 100 People Got Off the Bus and something like that. Oh yeah, Another 100 People, number 2. On there, look, is it focused in? Yeah. Another 100 people just got out of the plane. It's a really good song. I don't know what musical that's out of though. Then I've got Mel C, The Sea. And I liked this album, but not as much. Not as much. That's the second, I think that's a, not the most recent, but second to most recent one. And I had to order that online because it wasn't in the shops. Because it's all around CD. It's on a, speak, think and speak. It's her own label now, so she can do what she wants rather than being told what to do by record companies. Well, then I see, Think About It, that was the single, which is in here randomly. Oh, this is the album I didn't like by Mel C. I didn't like any of this very much at all, this album. No, there's nothing on there that I liked. It was too... The songs never got out of second gear, if you know what I mean. It sounded like it was just about to take off and they never did. Which has got a voice that can do stuff. And although sometimes you don't want to hear the full vocal range all the time, on that one, I'm contradicting myself, but it just felt like it needed at least one song to pick it up, and it just didn't have any of them. Who's next? MGMT. I think they had one song on here, which is what I liked. I can't remember where it was. I know the song off the top of my head, but I just can't get the words. MIA. Got this because... Is this the one that I'm thinking of? Oh, skipped one. No, I didn't like that MIA album. This is the MIA album that I like. I think it was the first one. Ooh, very shiny. Look at this. I liked Bamba Bonga and Bird Flu Boys, Jimmy. I think I liked a lot of this one. It was such a good album. So that's that one. Nearly finished. Oh my god. Didn't I hear a Michael Jackson CD? Just the one. Number ones. Yeah. So I think... Get in! Right, who's next? Murby, 18. That's quite normal. Sorry, I'm really uncomfortable right now. My back's starting to really ache. Murby, 18. I think we all know who Murby is, don't we? Then there's Murby Hotel. I didn't like that one at all, that Murby Hotel album. I liked 18, and I liked Play. I think this was one of them ones, wasn't it? I think it got a bit of a slate in there because he actually gave permission for all the songs on this. Every single one has been used for an advert. Every single one. And I think he was accused of being a sellout or something like that. But, so what? You know what I mean? He can do what he wants. Maloko. Then sing it back, bring it back, sing it back to me. That's that. That's a good album. Oops, that needs to go in there. And who's next? I've got Muta Buena. Song for Butter, yeah. A little bit. Yeah, I got that and I don't know why. Oh, Muta Buena. This is not real love with George Michael. I never knew she did a song with George Michael. Gosh, she must have done well to get that collaboration. And who's next? What's this? Oh, Natalie Imbruglia. But it's not got tone on there, so I don't know why I've got that. Natasha Bedingfield. These words are my own. How my heart feels. I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you. Nickelback, I don't know why I've got this. I don't even like them. Anyway, I've got a Nickelback album. What's next? I've got... Nicola Roberts from Girls Aloud. Now, I don't like Girls Aloud. Can't stand them. However, I do own this one, and this was such an underrated album. It was by the critics. It was critically acclaimed. They loved it, but people did not buy it, which is such a shame. Beat 'em a Drum was such a good, catchy song. Lucky Day was good. Yo-Yo's alright. Cinderella's Eyes was good. Porcelain Heart was good. Everyone's Gotta Learn Sometime is rubbish. I don't know why she released that as a single, or maybe that was the music record producer that decided to do that. Sticks and Stones was a great song. And Take a Bite as well. So it's a shame about that one. Nina Simone. This is another X Factor song on here. Ain't Got No Got Life was my song that got me through to the X Factor, which was on telly. But it's hard to find it now. Because it's not on YouTube anymore. There's... what else isn't it? I do love Nina Simone. Feeling Good. And Don't Let Me Be Misunderstood. Please don't let me be misunderstood. I love that song so much. Then I've got a greatest hits of Nina Simone as well. And got No Doubt, which I like very much. It's got the remix on this as well, hasn't it, of a song that I love so much. It's, I think, what's it? Oh, there's Hey Baby, I liked that one. Hey Baby, Hey Baby, Hey. Yeah, I think that's quite a normal album to own, No Doubt. No Doubt. Oasis, I don't have a few Oasis albums. And Dig Out Your Soul. And Don't Believe the Truth. What's the Story, Morning Glory. I've got The Offspring. Greatest Hits. I love The Offspring. I like that. Yes, I think that's quite a normal one. Gonna be a pretty fly for a white guy. Why don't you get a job? I love that song. Number 8. My friend's got a girlfriend and he hates that bitch. He tells me every day. Okay, go. Don't know why I got that, so that'll just go. Orson. Don't know why I've got that. Oh, Bright Idea. I think it was going to be an X Factor song. A lot of these albums, by the way, was just bought off very quickly because whenever I filled an audition to cheer me up, I'd buy an album. Owl City. I remember this, a lot of people having this as an audition song for X Factor in the queue, and I was so glad that I didn't. But I did like the song. It was Fireflies that I liked, number 9. But they turned out to be really religious-y as well, and in the end just got fed up of them. And pretty much there was only a one-hit wonder as well, weren't they? Plum Faith. I just can't rely on you. Yeah, you got the good stuff, but that won't last. I love that. I've got another Paloma Faith. I'm sure I think I've got two of her albums. Yeah, I did. I got the other one. Do You Know the Truth or Something Beautiful? Which I thought was a great album and a great song for that fact. Do you know the truth or something beautiful? I love that song. I've got three other albums. I've got, Fall to Grace. I got. And Picking Up the Pieces. Oh, yeah, that was another good song. Oh, yeah, I don't like Paloma Faith. Well, I liked her much more when she was more rare, in the sense of not everyone really knowing who she was. They just liked her songs, and then she got a bit too famous, and then she went a bit... I think she has got a bit funny, hasn't she? I got Paramore, just because I liked the one song, which was... I got this... What song did I like on this again? Something about the, what is it called? They've called it something different, the song, haven't they? I can't remember where it was now. Dude. Oh, what's it called, that song? I can't remember. Something about win the war or something. Paul Eaton. I only bought that because, I do actually remember I only bought this because it was on some sort of offer, like, buy two CDs for 10 quid from HMV. And I got that album for like something like a pound or something. So that's why I got that. Peter Andre! No way! Oh, that is shameful. That is shameful, isn't it? I don't know any of these songs at all. Oh my word. That is shocking. It's not even got Mysterious Girl on it for a joke, you know? I've got a Pink album. Greatest Hits, and I've got Misunderstood as well by Pink. I've got a Queen album, or two. I've got two. It's Queen. Everyone needs a Queen album. So that I know that is entirely normal, no matter what anyone says. Who is this? Rachel Stevens, another underrated singer. She was in S Club 7. And I think the song I liked that was Sweet Dreams, My LAX was a really good song. And, yeah. But she was very underrated. Do you know what? I actually remember buying this from Asda. Because when I first got the CD, I got home and someone had robbed the CD out the case. And I got all the way home and I wasn't embarrassed, but I was worried that when I went back to Asda to say, look, I bought this album and someone's nicked it. I've heard the fact that I was going to say, yeah, you're just trying to get your money back, but I actually wanted to buy another one, so it would have made no sense, would it? Right, so Radiohead, the best of. Obviously, Creep is a song that gets used on singing competitions way too much. But I did have it, I think I did have it first as one of my first songs for auditioning, but it was like in the first two series of X Factor, it was a song that I had as a backup. And I think it did get me through to round two on maybe series three, but then everyone started singing it. Red Hot Chili Peppers, Greatest Hits, that's a normal album to own, I think, as is The Best of R.E.M., I think. Richard X, there's some really good songs on that. It was like a Liberty X song on Richard X, which was Be Nobody, which was so good. It was such a good remix. I loved that. Renee Fleming, which I bought, not just because we share the same name. No relation at all, but I did like her version of the song Endlessly, which randomly I saw on, I think it was This Morning, which is a TV morning television programme sort of thing in the UK. I think it was presented at the time by Philip and Fern, which I preferred. I liked it when it was Phil and Fern, rather than Ollie Willoughby. Do you know what? Actually, I'm going to say it now. You know everyone thinks that Ollie Willoughby is so lovely. Actually, she was quite mean to me in X Factor, so I'll put that out there. I don't like to name drop, but if someone's horrible to me, then I will tell them. Rihanna, rated R, I bought this. I don't have many Rihanna albums. I think I've only got the one. I do only have the one. And I think I bought it because of Russian Roulette. I did like that song. I don't really like Rihanna. I think she's really overrated. Really overrated. I think she's just got really good managers. And I think one time she was nearly declared bankrupt because she doesn't write any of her own stuff. Well, I think she has started to now. But back in the day, even with Umbrella, she didn't earn that much money at all because she was just a singer. She didn't write anything. And she didn't do many gigs either, or something daft like that. I've got, what's his name again? Robbie Williams. I do like this album, but I can't remember which song I love. I can't remember which song it is on there. I really like it, though. I'll know it when I hear it, but I can't remember what song it is. We're nearly done, people. This is a very long video, isn't it? What's this? Rasheen Murphy. I do like Rasheen Murphy. Our songs do go on a bit too long. I do like Overpowered. I have got this a few of these songs on my phone that I listen to. Roy Orbison, Best Of. Because obviously it was an X Factor song, which was I Drove All Night. And I think that's pretty much it. Pretty Woman's a good song as well, isn't it? Pretty Woman, walking down the street, Pretty Woman. Sam Sparrow. This is another singer that suffered badly because of X Factor. Not because he was on it, but because everyone's audition song was Sam Sparrow. And everyone was fed up of hearing Sam Sparrow songs in the audition rooms. It was really ridiculous. Everyone was singing it. Sash, the Best Of. Stay! We're nearly done, people. We're nearly done. Look, because I'm having to move up. Scarlet. I do remember this because I think it was a play or something. An independent love song is such a good song. It's so underrated. You might think this is an in.